Erythema toxicum, also known as erythema neonatorum, is a common skin rash that affects newborn babies. The condition usually appears within the first few days of life and is characterized by red bumps or patches on the skin. The condition is harmless and usually resolves on its own without any medical intervention. However, it can cause concern among new parents, who may mistake it for a more serious condition. In this video, we will explore erythema toxicum overview, meaning, causes, sign, symptoms, diagnosis, treatment, home remedies, and frequently asked questions. By the way, welcome to our channel. Don't forget to thumb up and subscribe. What is the meaning of erythema toxicum, word by word? Erythema refers to redness or inflammation of the skin, while toxicum refers to a toxic substance. Therefore, erythema toxicum literally means redness or inflammation caused by a toxic substance. However, despite its name, erythema toxicum is not actually caused by a toxic substance, but rather by a normal reaction to the baby's environment after birth. Causes of erythema toxicum. The exact cause of erythema toxicum is not known. However, it is believed to be a reaction to the environment in which the baby is born. The condition is more common in babies who are born full-term and is less common in premature babies. Signs and symptoms of erythema toxicum. The symptoms of erythema toxicum usually appear within the first few days of life and can last up to 2 weeks. The condition is characterized by the following: red bumps or patches on the skin, small white or yellow bumps in the center of the red patches. The rash can appear on the face, trunk, arms, and legs. The rash may be accompanied by mild itching or discomfort, but it is usually not painful. Diagnosis of erythema toxicum. Erythema toxicum is diagnosed by its characteristic appearance. A doctor or nurse can usually identify the rash based on its appearance alone. In rare cases, a skin biopsy may be performed to confirm the diagnosis. Treatment of erythema toxicum. Erythema toxicum usually does not require any medical treatment, as it will resolve on its own within a few days. There is no specific treatment for erythema toxicum, as the condition usually resolves on its own within a few days. However, parents can take steps to keep their baby comfortable while the rash is present. This includes keeping the affected area clean and dry, dressing the baby in loose-fitting clothing, and avoiding harsh soaps or detergents that may irritate the skin. Prevention of erythema toxicum. There is no way to prevent erythema toxicum, as it is a reaction to the environment in which the baby is born. However, parents can take steps to reduce the risk of other skin conditions by keeping their baby's skin clean and dry, using mild soaps and detergents, and avoiding harsh chemicals and fragrances. Complications of erythema toxicum. Erythema toxicum is a harmless condition that usually does not cause any complications. However, in rare cases, it may be accompanied by other symptoms, such as fever or difficulty breathing. If your baby experiences any of these symptoms, you should seek medical attention immediately. In some cases, erythema toxicum may be mistaken for other skin conditions, such as a bacterial or viral infection. If your baby's rash does not look like erythema toxicum, or if it is accompanied by other symptoms, such as a fever or difficulty breathing, you should see a doctor. When should we go to the doctor? In most cases, erythema toxicum is a harmless condition that does not require medical treatment. However, if your baby experiences any symptoms in addition to the rash, such as a fever, difficulty breathing, or signs of infection, you should seek medical attention immediately. Additionally, if you are unsure whether your baby's rash is erythema toxicum or another skin condition, you should consult a doctor to rule out any potential complications. It is always better to err on the side of caution when it comes to your baby's health. Home remedies for erythema toxicum. There are no specific home remedies for erythema toxicum, as the condition usually resolves on its own. However, parents can take certain steps to keep their baby comfortable while the rash is present, such as keeping the affected area clean and dry, dressing the baby in loose-fitting clothing. Avoiding harsh soaps or detergents that may irritate the skin. Frequently asked questions about erythema toxicum. Is erythema toxicum a contagious condition? No, erythema toxicum is not contagious and cannot be spread to other people. Can erythema toxicum cause long-term skin damage? No, erythema toxicum is a harmless condition that does not usually cause long-term skin damage. Can erythema toxicum recur in the future? No. Erythema toxicum is a self-limiting condition that usually resolves on its own within a few days. Does erythema toxicum require medical treatment? Erythema toxicum usually does not require medical treatment, as it will resolve on its own within a few days. However, if the rash is accompanied by other symptoms, such as fever or difficulty breathing, the baby should be seen by a doctor. How can I prevent erythema toxicum in my newborn baby? There is no way to prevent erythema toxicum, as it is a reaction to the environment in which the baby is born. Are erythema multiforme, erythema nodosum, erythema infectiosum, erythema toxicum, and erythema marginatum similar conditions? Are there any differences between them? Erythema multiforme, erythema nodosum, erythema infectiosum, erythema toxicum, and erythema marginatum are all skin conditions that involve redness of the skin due to inflammation. The reason why they all have erythema in their names is that erythema is a medical term that refers to redness of the skin caused by inflammation. While these skin conditions share the feature of redness and inflammation, they have different causes and pathophysiologies. For example, erythema nodosum is a type of panniculitis that results from a delayed hypersensitivity reaction to various triggers, such as infections, medications, and autoimmune diseases. In contrast, erythema multiforme is a hypersensitivity reaction to certain medications or infections, such as herpes simplex virus or mycoplasma. Erythema marginatum is a skin rash that is associated with rheumatic fever, while erythema infectiosum is a viral infection caused by parvovirus B19. Erythema toxicum, on the other hand, is a common rash in newborns that is benign and self-limited. Therefore, these conditions have different pathophysiologies and causes, and should be diagnosed and treated properly by a healthcare provider. Thanks for watching. Take care and stay safe.